al mundo demostrando su esplendor. Sueños de artesanos laboriosos que se tejen cual rebozos.
The municipality of Tenancingo is located 66 miles southeast of Mexico City in the mountainous valley of Toluca, Toluca capital of the state of Mexico. Altitudes are in the mile high range. The town of Tenancingo has a population of 72,000. Growing flowers and marketing cut flowers is a major industry. On Wednesdays, there is an extensive flower market. Another industry is products made using knitting machines. Tenancingo is known for the weaving of traditional cotton warp dyed jaspe, ikat, rebozos. Early each September, there is a fiesta of rebozos. The major rebozo market is on Sundays, a smaller market on Thursdays. Local rebozo weavers and fringe makers, putadores, a specialized skill, and those from the surrounding areas of the municipality hold a market in one of the principal streets of the town. This weaver, Maria Luis Salinas, is from a small town, Acatzingo, very near Tenancingo. At one time, a third of the population wove rebozos. Now it is about 40 rebozo weavers. We learn how to fold a rebozo first in half lengthwise, then in quarters, then in half, end to end, and finally in quarters in such a way as to protect the fringe. From July 31st through August 11, Hillary Steele, colleague, friend, and also weaver, and I, Virginia Davis, learned how to weave the jaspe rebozo on the traditional telar de otate backstrap loom with Don Evaristo Borboa Casas, the winner of the Grand National Prize for Master Artisans. He maintains the old technique of the backstrap loom. This is a detail of the fourth from the left rebozo.
If you learn this first, you
should. Es el original.
Sí.
Es el. El telar original de Tenancingo.
Sí. But nobody really learns this anymore.
Pero nadie lo aprende.
Oh, qué lástima.
Como es más lento, más calmado. Dice, no, ¿qué es? No, allá se avanza. Allá se avanza más. Y por ese motivo, era.
Entonces,
no les interesa.
No. Sí, it's faster, but it's not as...
No, es, no es imaginativo.
Es
no
trabajo.
Entonces, yo ya puedo hacer lo mismo que hago aquí, lo puedo hacer allá.
Sí.
Existió, bueno, más bien dicho, hubo un milagro que un sacerdote a un grupo de gente le regaló un Cristo, un nazareno, cargando su cruz.
Sí.
Y entonces, una monja lo visitaba mucho. Cuando no tenía trabajo, el estudio, lo que hacían a diario, se iba a estar ahí con él. Ahí estaba. Se enfermó ella, la monja. Y la monja usaba un rebocito. Y entonces, se llegó el momento en que la monja estuvo en cama, ya no podía irlo a ver. Y ella le decía, Señor, ven a verme. Ya ves que yo siempre, nunca te olvido, siempre estoy contigo. Y entonces, al ver eso, pues, ella le pedía en la cama. Y entonces las hermanas, las compañeras, decían, pero ¿cómo? A ver, vamos a ver al Señor. Sí, ella siempre estaba con él, a ver, vamos a ver. Y entonces fue y tenía aquí en el hombro el rebozo. Y allí le pusieron el Señor del rebozo. Y yo lo tengo aquí, aquí en la capilla de la esquina esa. Ahí está el Señor del rebozo. Ahora que se vayan, pasan. Aquí en la capilla esa que está ahí.
Sí.
Hasta adentro, a la derecha, ahí está. Yo después saqué una copia yo de allá de México. Y les dije a los compañeros reboceros, ¿saben qué? Para que sea nuestro patrón acá hay que traerlo. Y ya lo compramos. Tiene como 14 años aquí conmigo.
14 años.
Sí,
muy joven.
En una ocasión.
The rebozo was copied, and now we can purchase it almost anywhere. Don Evaristo shows us the demonstration miniature models he made of the process. First a finished piece. Then we see a sequence of undyed warp, tied warp, design dyed warp, and foundation and loom. These were made to illustrate an article. This is a current commission being woven by Don Evaristo. First, we go to buy the yarn from a local merchant, Vicente Vasquez Terragora. The yarn is made in Mexico and is very fine, 80 over 2. There are approximately 3,400 feet per pound. A pound is $9. Our finished rebozo will have approximately 100 ends per inch and will be 45 inches long and 19 inches wide. Don Evaristo is making bobbins for warping. He has made all of his own equipment. With the bobbins, he is now making the warp, which will have groups for marking and tying the design. There are 16 threads in each group for the resist design. There is a cross at each end of the warp. There are 56 such groups. It is a long, time-consuming process. Now the warp is stretched outside to prepare it for marking the design. It has been starched with a cornstarch atole. Atole. De maíz. While separating the groups, we see Don Evaristo's teaching method. We watch him do the process several times. Then it is turned over to us. He corrects mistakes hand on.
It's a twining motion.
I know. I'm so confused. Uno momento.
This is repeated until we learn correctly. Hillary is trying to achieve the correct separation. Finally, the warp groups are separated. The starch is being squeezed out. These are the designs that will be marked on the warp.
Well, he's using this tool with the thin blade instead of a pincel, a brush.
Now we are doing the marking for calabrote. Don Evaristo is using a thin metal marker.
O sea, aquí, aquí se le amarra, aquí, 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 y aquí es chiquito, es grande, se le llena.
Side by side, we see calabrote and tres labores. Sí. The two designs are compared. Now, Don Evaristo begins to tie the warps for the design.
Todo esto es lo que se amarra al centro de, la, de lo que se rayó.
Mm-hmm. In the center of
sí,
the marks.
Sí, que no quede así.
Sí.
Todo mm-hmm. chueco, no, debe de quedar al centro, todo al centro.
Mm-hmm. He uses a thin cotton twine for making the resist tie. It is also wetted so that it will tighten when it dries. There is still starch in the warp so that the threads will not twist. When the tying is finished, the warp is twisted and beaten to break up the starch.
Oh. To break up the starch.
Okay. Then it is washed again and sequentially beaten and wetted on stones in the yard of the workshop to remove the starch. This goes on for about 20 minutes.
Let's get through.
Cualquier tipo de rebozo haya, pero siempre cuando, para que convenga, 20, 15 por lo menos, 12 por lo menos. Allá. Entonces se pueden pintar y hacer. Yo puedo hacer muchas cosas. Esto que hago aquí yo lo puedo hacer en el baño. ¿Por qué? ¿Por qué? Mm. Ellos no. Les falta mucho. Sí. Conocer para poder hacer esto allá.
They're lacking the thought process. Sí.
Sí.
Porque no hay tiempo. Es más rápido.
Pero aquí es
posible. Sí, creo que aquello es más barato.
We see his floor loom production center. 5 looms. Here one has the warp on it and a warping reel.
Yo ya puedo hacer una tela de 16 de estos. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Así un montón, así.
Sí.
Yo hago.
Sí.
Sí.
We walk back to the work area. Don Evaristo enters his dye facility. He has mixed up a basic black dye with a salt of sulfur in this can and uses it to dye the warp. He dips about 50 times and then squeezes and wrings the dye out, washes it, ring some more. After the warp dries under tension, it is necessary to remove the knots. Don Evaristo cuts them with a knife. It takes a steady hand and steady nerves. It's unbelievable. After removing the tying threads, the warp groups are separated. Each group has a complete design.
cuatro.
Again, the warp is kept under tension. Now we are preparing to make the fondo warp. The fondo is the background of solid colors without the tied jaspe resist pattern. This is the foundation warp. It's going to be a sequence of black and white stripes that will go in between each of the design motif groups. Since a third of the fondo will remain white, it will be separated for dyeing. Don Evaristo tells us to pick up one cross, two threads, for the white, hold it on two fingers, then pick up two crosses, four threads, for the black, and hold on a different two fingers. Repeat this sequence across the entire warp. In this way, the black warp is separated and the white can be held out of the dye. The fondo is measured against the jaspe warp so that the fringe length on the white fondo can be measured and dyed black. The fondo is evened out. The marking of the fringe length is now being completed. Its ends are being wrapped with plastic so that it can be lifted out of the dye. The fondo is gathered and taken to the dye kitchen. The dried fondo is placed under tension beside the jaspe warp. You can see the black and white stripes of the fondo and the totally black fringe.
Are you going to intermix them?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Here the starch is removed by wetting and pounding.
Bueno.
Again, both warps are stretched and dried under tension. Don Evaristo separates the threads using a stiff bristle brush. He now explains that we have to integrate the two warps. The warp is mounted inside for integration work. With both warps in his left hand, the jaspe warp on top, Don Evaristo transforms one group of the design, then a group of the stripes to his right hand. He keeps the alternate odd and even threads in order. The new sequence is then tied by groups on one bar of the backstrap loom. The width is marked on a bar that will be at the other end of the warp. This is where the weaving will start, at the other end. The cross is opened and separated.
Para separar.
Es comprar el jueves de todos.
The threads are brushed to help separate. A second round bar, which will hold the heddles, is put in, and also a second bar to maintain the cross. The heddles for lifting every other thread will be placed on the round bar. The same number 80 thread is used to make the heddles. It is difficult to pick up every other thread because of the thread's fineness. The heddle is completed and a shed, an opening, is made. A stick, el sosopatle, a sword in English, is packing the warp down and helps to move the group of alternate threads to make the next opening for the next crossing thread. A broken thread. It is a delicate operation to repair this.
No, he's repairing a thread. Yeah.
Next, the weft thread must pass sequentially through the correct opening or shed and can't be twisted or include threads from below. The shuttle flips through fast. A second opening is made. Don Evaristo shows us how to use our finger in helping to make this opening.
Oh, mira.
Don Evaristo says that it's a conversation between the two layers of the warp. Thank you. The rhythm continues swiftly. We see the dance, the rhythm of body movement and timing with the process of weaving. Underneath is a templero to maintain the width of the weaving. The weaving is progressively rolled toward the other end. Finally, at the completion of the weaving, it is removed from the tie. The finished weaving is rolled up so that it can be within reach for ending the process. Now the heddles are removed. The heddle thread is saved. We see the completed weaving. The threads at the beginning of the weaving, the ones that were put in to establish the width, are removed. The weaving is removed from the back bar. A detail. We delight in the result. Demostrando su esplendor. Sueños de artesanos laboriosos que se tejen cual rebozos muy dentro del corazón. Y los que entrelazan con suspiros y que pintan con figuras llenas de luz y color. Y que entre las manos amorosas forman puntas majestuosas con mil nudos. Una de las grandes tradiciones es llevar rebozo al hombro, ofreciendo al comprador prendas con figuras de colores que con nuditos de amores dibujó el amarrador. Y que en el telar de los pedales o en otate en la cintura puso trama el tejedor. Que lo luzca como reina los domingos en la plaza, muy del brazo de su amor.